Hello friends, I am Dr. Sirajul Faizi. I welcome you in my YouTube channel. Today in this video, I am going to show you some lab equipments. So first, this is very simple. It is known as beaker. Simple container for stirring, mixing and heating liquids. You know, generally cylindrical in shape with a flat bottom and lip for pouring. You can see the lip, this one is a lip. Available in wide range of size from 1 milliliter up to 7 liters. Now, Erlenmeyer flask, you know, this is a flat conical body and a cylindrical neck. Allows content to be swirled or stirred during an experiment. Narrow neck, you can see neck is narrow, keeps the content from spilling out and reduce evaporative losses compared to a beaker. So Erlenmeyer flask. Now volumetric flask, you know, flat bottomed bulb with a long neck, usually fitted with a stopper. A neck has a single ring graduation mark and a label. You can see the label, 500 milliliter, and here you can see the mark. Used for making solution to a known volume. Graduated cylinder is used to accurately measure the volume of an object. More accurate and precise for this purpose than flask and beaker. Now test tube, common piece of glassware consisting of a finger-like length of glass or clear plastic tubing, open at the top, usually with rounded U-shaped shaped bottom, and you can see available in multitude of the lengths and width, typically from 10 to 20 mm wide and 50 to 200 mm long. Now beaker tongs. Tongs used to carry a beaker after it has been subjected to heat or cold temperature. Now, crucible tong. Tongs used to carry a crucible after it has been subjected to heat or cold temperature. So friends, this is crucible, and now you can see here test tube holder, a gripping device used to carry a test tube after it has been subjected to heat or cold temperature. Now you can see test tube brush. This is very useful in chemistry laboratory. Device used to clean the inside of test tube or other long necked glassware. Scopula, utensil used to transfer solid, usually in powder form. Thermometer, a device used to measure the temperature of a substance, and this is very useful. And forceps, handled hinged instruments are used for grasping and holding objects, used when fingers are too large to grasp small objects, or when many objects need to be held at one time while hands are used to perform a task. Now medicine dropper. You know friends, usually glass tube tapered to a narrow point and fitted with a rubber bulb at the top, used to transfer a small quantities of liquid. Test tube rack, used to hold or support test tubes containing chemicals awaiting for further operation. And now you can see glass stirring rod, a piece of lab equipment used to mix chemicals and liquid for laboratory purposes, usually made of solid glass about the thickness of a drinking straw. Now you can see the Bunsen burner, piece of laboratory equipment that produces a single open gas flame, which is used for heating, sterilization and combustion. Now you can see the retort stand, retort, a piece of scientific equipment so onto which clamp can be attached to hold test tube and other equipment such as burette. So C clamp, you can see this is very useful. You should know the name of this, otherwise during laboratory how you ask your instructor. A device shaped like a C, used to hold or secure objects to a retort stand. Now you can see the burette, a vertical cylindrical piece of laboratory glassware with a volumetric graduations on its full length and precision tape or stopcock on the bottom, used to dispense known amounts of a liquid in experiments for which precision is necessary, a titration experiment. Now, wire mesh, a semi-permeable barrier made of connected strands of metal fibers or other flexible or ductile material. Now, clay triangle, used to hold a crucible while the crucible is heated. Now, crucible originally used for metal, glass and pigment production. A crucible is a container that can withstand temperature high enough to melt or otherwise alter its content. Now, funnel, used to channel liquids or fine grained substances into containers with a small opening. So, filter paper, a semi-permeable paper barrier placed perpendicular to a liquid or airflow, used to separate fine solid from the liquids or air. Mortar and pestle, a tools used to crush, grind and mix solid substances. The pestle is heavy, a bat shaped object, the end of which is used for crushing and grinding. The mortar is a ball typically made of hard wood, ceramics or stone. This is the spot plate. You know, this spot plate is ceramic plate with a small wheels. You can see a small wheels or depressions built into it, used to perform reactions on a very small amount of materials. Evaporating dish, a porcelain or ceramic dish used to evaporate excess water or other solvent to ensure that the concentration solution or the dissolved substance is left behind. Now you can see the petri dish, a shallow glass or plastic cylindrical lidded dish that biologist used to culture cells. So my friends, I hope this video will be helpful to you. If you like this video, then subscribe my channel, and thanks for watching.